will be seeing class 12 business studies chapter 10 financial market. In that we have understood that there are two types of markets, money market and capital market. We understood the meaning of money market. Now we have to see what are the instruments of money market. In the features when we were discussing, we saw that there are certain instruments that are to be used in the money market. The first instrument of money market is call money. Now call money is nothing but a money borrowed or lent for a shorter period of time when short period transaction takes place. That is specifically one day. When one day shortage is there, the shortage is there for one day and transaction takes place for one day. If borrower lent transaction takes place for one day, it is known as call money. Now generally what happens, now it includes generally one day except Sunday and holidays, and this kind of shortages are generally with the banks. Banks may have a shortage of one day reserve for which they approach the other bank who is having surplus cash, and that bank who is having surplus cash will give the money to the bank who is having shortage, but it will be given only for one day and on the interest. Now this is a temporary shortage that has taken place, and so the transaction that takes place between two banks is known as interbank call money transfer. Generally if you see, banks will be involved in these kind of transactions for shorter period of time, but insurance and mutual fund companies are also involved in such transactions. Why banks are using it, this kind of transactions? Because they need to maintain minimum requirement of CRR, that is cash reserve ratio. We all know that banks have to keep certain cash as reserve. If any emergency or shortage is there, they can utilize this money. But if shortage is there in this, then they can approach the banks who are having surplus and they can take a one day loan from them, they can borrow the money from them. But they have to pay interest on that. And that interest is called as, what the interest they are paying is called as call rate. The interest that bank is paying on taking borrowing money is known as call rate. And interest paid on the call money is volatile. Volatile means it keeps on changing. And how frequently it changes? It varies from day to day. Day to day. Maybe today the rate of interest is different. Tomorrow the rate of interest will be different. Or it may change hourly also. Hour to hour basis also there are possibilities that rate of interest will change. So this is call money. Call money is nothing but when money is borrowed or lent for a shorter period of time, specifically one day. And the interest that we are paying on that is called as call rate. Generally, call money transactions take place between banks. So it is called as interbank call money transactions. Second type is treasury bills. Second instrument of money market is treasury bill. Money market, you remember the concept, in that only the concept itself says that for short period of time the finance has to be arranged. So all the instruments will be related to short period only. Treasury bills. Now these bills are issued by Reserve Bank of India on behalf of Government of India. So can we say that these are the safest instruments because they are issued by Reserve Bank of India. So people will take it, they will not hesitate, they will not feel insecure. Why this kind of bill is needed? So that it can enhance the government to get short-term borrowings. Government can arrange short-term borrowings because these bills are being sold to banks and to general public. So government can raise the money through treasury bills in a shorter period of time. Because these are being issued by RBI, they are safe and bank and public will be ready to take it. It is a negotiable instrument and freely transferable. If you want to transfer from one person to another, it is possible and it is negotiable instrument. Whereas it is issued at discount. It is issued at discount, or you can say it is issued at price lower than their fair value and repaid at the par. when it is being issued, it is issued at discount, or maybe it is issued at a price lower than the face value, and when you are returning back, you are being paid at par for whatever amount that time you should get, you will get that. The maturity period for treasury bills is generally from 14 days to 364 days. You have to utilize your treasury bill, you have to get repaid your treasury bill, you have to give back your treasury bill, the maturity between 14 days to 364 days. And it is available for minimum cost of 25,000 rupees and then in multiples thereof. So minimum requirement should be for 25,000 rupees and later you can increase it. So these are two instruments of money market that we have seen today. In the next video we will be seeing more. So stay tuned in. Do not forget to subscribe. Do like, comment and share, and please let me know if you have any queries. I will be making video for that also. Thank you.